what?
So we is from New England, but our store is set in England, England.
Say, play me some of that opening number.
Come along, you sinners all, and listen to our songs. Attention, short, we come to naught, so it won't last too long.
We're gonna tell the story of how we came to be, about our humble origin and foolish history.
Our central character.
Protagonist. Hero.
We're sorry. It's historical conceit.
You mean when fops and dandies strutted at the courts?
Fops and dandies!
Hello there.
And the greatest minds developed natural philosophy.
Philosophy?
It's what we now call science.
Oh. Science. Oh.
Building the first calculators.
Oh.
Steam turbines.
Oh.
And
I just invented the telescope!
Cromwell's Puritans had been outwitted and would stop at nothing to bring down a new hedonistic world of playhouses and God-challenging investigation.
Yeah. Are you saying we don't like the Puritans?
Hell no, we don't like the Puritans!
And any Puritans in the audience, what are you doing here? This is the theater?
That sounds like one hell of an interesting century.
I sure as hell want to see that. Do you want to see that?
Yes!
Do you want to see that?
Yeah!
Do you want to see that?
Yeah!
Well then, let's play on!
2, 3, 4!
To see you two, let's fall through! Woo! To see you two, let's fall through!
Oh!
Again. Go again!
Young lord who cries out,
"Lights!"
Thou dost not even know.
I must vent.
Anyway, I must. You done? Sorry.
I must vent of course to find the father I never knew and whose identity you have ever kept from me. Oh, I must vent on all the roads and seas of this world to find my one true love. Oh, mother, it has become a nightly burning burden in my young and tempestuous breast. These voices I must obey. I shall seek adventure in foreign parts. In short, I shall depart! Hear that, dear mama? The howling has ceased. No sooner hath my quill scratched a word apart upon this paper than the calm must doth descend. My fate is foretold. I leave shortly. At first sight I shall shortly leave. Shortly! Your most earnestly and shortly departing son, Fools.
He's got a letter.
Oh, you should
have said. Oh, a letter! Light! Ink! Parchment! My son has written to me, and apparently in his sleep, and must be dissuaded from imminent departure, as only a mother can dissuade. My dearest and only son Fools, imagine my distress when in the early hours of the morning I kept awake by your nightly raving. The malodorous smithic arrived, breathless, red-faced and sweaty, clutching your foreboding missive in his podgy paw. Is this the reward for mother's care? Are watchful nights driven to distraction not enough that you must threaten me with imminent departure? Oh, you selfish boy! Slightly ungrateful. My darling boy, your affectionate and loving mother, Lady Esther Winch.
Hi,
Esther.
Dearest mamma, I fear you are too harsh on Smevik. In the absence of the male sibling whom you have denied to me, Smevik has taken the place of a brother. Let him huff and sweat how he will. Your only gift to me has been my sister, Philadelphia.
Oh, Phils!
True, I love her as a brother should. True, she's like a milkmaid. From the sweet fields. True, the bird's cry. She's even constructed her own lyre made from wood and string and strangely futuristic bolts. But still, she's my sister and only a girl. True, she has read me all the natural philosophers, if only I understood her reading. No man finds a clever woman clever. I am still leaving, very shortly.
Philadelphia and her lyre, away!
I cannot be swayed in this my very manly resolve as I head to the city full of knowledgeable and stylish men who shall guide me. Your ever dutiful and yet departing son, Fools.
My dearest darling little boy,
I... Pray do not dare!
shall, dear and darling, you to my heart's content. For it's I that carried you, nourished you with my own blood, and brought you into this world at the midst of the most exquisite pain caused to my southern polar region.
Oh, once more you summon your pain as a goad with which to bait me.
I have not finished my letter, the long-suffering and tender-hearted mother.
Finish now.
Yes.
Then I shall stay, but only if you tell me who my father is.
Oh, silly boy, why must you leave? What can possibly be out there that you can't find at home?
Because I want to know why the sky is blue.
Sky.
Why the sun burns eternally. Oh, what matter is that? What is yet? Water. All these things I would know. Who is my father? Then I shall leave penniless, loyal Swiss was to Ponica. I shall away, fetch me my bridle, saddle, bit.
But what about the horse? I knew horse to rely on you.
Dong.
My dearest, let me clasp you by.
my dear young filly. What a splendidly warm welcome.
Lord, my brother Fools, parson. Do forgive me if I seem too familiar.
And to what were you going to clasp me, my dear? I think you were going to say, bosom, were you not? Oh, do you ogling women not have some pots to polish? Are there no floors to scrub? Idle hands are the devil's work. And you, pudgy little man, we must be busy, busy, busy. And my hands are always busy, I assure you. Be about your business.
No, parson! No, parson! No, parson! No, parson, hands up, you are here. You've answered a distressed woman's call. You should not find me ungrateful, I assure you.
Bye.
words that the traveller spoke to sister in such strange accent. Some sort of almost English.
Looks like you're in trouble there, boy.
Where you come from, daddy-o?
I come from the environs of Winch. I've travelled for days across the plains. I've headed for the city of London to learn of natural philosophy at the hands of experts. But I've lost my mount.
Lost your mind, Borla.
I'm in great need of a steed.
He needs a steed.
Should the cops stop that feed? Not off to see your type around these parts.
My type? Methinks, sister dear, they did mean to make reference to my hue. Haven't we often laughed about it? How strange my appearance is for our quiet town. How historically inaccurate it is. I'm afraid no one would think of that again. My type?
You know, the Ottoman look.
Ottoman?
You know, the Turkish Empire from the 1600s, they ruled over half the known world.
Oh, Ottoman! Like little Ali Kababa here!
That's an Ottoman.
Assalamu alaikum. Khalini arraf nafsi. Ana Ali Kababa. It is an honor to meet with a fellow from my clan. I bring with me the scent of the cedars of Lebanon, the zest of the lemons of Cairo, and the mysteries of the moss of Constantinople.
Lucky little fella, ain't he?
They're real clever with the math and stuff.
And the stars.
Ali Kababa here can read the sky like it's a book.
Mighty heavens! Perhaps Ali Kababa can tell me where my...
Whoa. Don't jump the gun, son.
Right now, you're gonna need a horse.
Where can I find a horse when I have no money?
Wow, you still got clothes, ain't you?
And so, sister mine, I did most mournfully divest me a pint of barrel.
To a trader drifting racks and bones, he gave his clothes and pawn. In his birthday suit he wandered on, as nude as he was born. Gave that cash for a brand new horse.
Oh, I'll write you tomorrow.
Immigrants.
He doth have a lost piece.
town. This fox is wounded. He is spent.
Oh, wherein lies your option, you pointless dates? Without your heels, your doublets, your stockings, you are as naked and helpless as he. What are you, ladies and gentlemen, I'm coming towards you. What are you without your wigs, your pals, your cosmetics, madam? But just such a wretch as this, herein lies the truth of all. This mister who merely asks for help! And besides, don't miss his sister.
Oh. Indeed, dear Philly, it's a good thing that Ian isn't here at all. That Nina seemed most touched and used in my separation from you, and insisted they tell me their own tale of woe, which they did in song.
Bye, boys!
Shimmering.
The way he bends his neck.
Look how he smiles with glee.
It is indefinite.
It really has to be.
I declare it's true. You are the living embodiment of our noble but absent leader, Filbert Tate Modern.
Kiss!
Philly, once again I am compared to another man. This must be my father. But wait, what eastern sorcery is this?
This is I, Lord Clarendon, Chancellor to Charles II, King of England.
Lord Clarendon, what is your will?
Is anyone here called Waterlesby? Other way, legs, other. I come direct from the king. We have reason to believe that your father, Filbert Tate Modern,
yes,
is plotting to bring down the realm. He has turned the Royal Society into a sham and a laughing stock.
He has.
He's absent, and you must stop him. Lord Clarendon, away.
Father, have I found you and I'm so soon your enemy?
Fabrice, we do help this man, Mortalsby,
defeat Filbert, who by all accounts
has turned out to be a complete lunatic.
Shall we not be back in favour with the king?
Thus back in the court.
Fops, I think I see a return to our former glory.
I'm straight to Philadelphia.
There's no time for letters. We must adorn you in the radiant raiment of natural philosophy. Fops, dress him.
My dearest Billy, no time to write. Upon what adventures am I now embarked? Who knows if I shall ever return? Farewell, sister.
All right, sit down, everybody. Come quickly, come on.
Why do you sit
down? All right, quiet, everybody. Because back in Winch, Philadelphia's gonna sing her song. Philadelphia. Why don't you give me a
private rendition.
Oh,
fools! Fools better get this puffin business done soon, hey?
Yeah, real fast.
Cause things are not looking good for Philly and her mom.
Well, England had,
at that time,
a place for all the eggheads to do
all the clever stuff that would one day become
space flying,
robot,
and the internet.
And it was called
the
Royal
Society.
And it was harder to get into than a rat's rear end.
And the people in it were so educated.
It's so cultured
that we just had to sing some Monteverdi.
Oh, that's nice.
I'm feeling so cultured.
So, what do they do, these philosophers?
You hear of Newton?
Apple on head guy.
You got it.
Listen.
Dangerous time, Sir Philbert. Just the matter of the final password.
of the greatest discoveries of all time.
Yes, and you're almost there. You two will put England on the scientific map forever!
So the Royal Society isn't the same. It's not saving the realm or undermining the king.
No! Only a Puritan Dutch spy would want that. No, the king is very proud of his society, which is why His Majesty is visiting this very afternoon.
The king's
help! Help! Help!
What we're doing is good. We're all fine. The king is proud. It's all.
Ah! Philip!
I'm a genius.
Come on! Let me show you my new telescope! It's a reflector!
Everything is upside down.
Exactly. I knew you'd get it.
And if we pointed out that window.
Across the road, you can see Mrs. Watson's tits!
Are you sure you're Sir Isaac Newton?
Yeah, dude. Even a great natural philosopher needs a thrill sometimes.
Look! You can see all the way to your old home in a winch!
He's tied her up, and mother is suspended from a tower by a shoelace. There's a banner. It says,
"Discredit Newton and all English science now, or they both die."
Oh, please,
I am sending an emissary to ensure they comply.
Determined to take down your foppish king and his Catholic ways and put a true Puritan upon the throne. And now, you will help Ali, or only ever see your mother and sister as they are fed in pieces through the bars of your cage.
Ali Kebaba, stop! Why?
Oh, do not be too harsh on the little Ottoman fools. I found him in an old oil lamp in Istanbul. I rubbed it and there he was. And what could the little chap do? Yes, master. What is your will, master? Kebaba, conceal yourself.
What would you have me do?
Listen very close.
I must put down the Royal Society to ensure Dutch dominance.
Yes, and all in good time, for here comes the king.
All right, His Majesty.
Italian tunes and French dances, am I right? Flodgy! Isaac, good to see you again. Philbert, good to have you back. And all my philosophers working so hard to make England the most powerful nation on earth. Have they been working hard, madam?
Of course.
Your Majesty. That's good. I'm glad to hear they have been working hard because today, their charter is up for renewal.
Ooh.
And they'd better hope they don't disappoint.
Sorry, why don't you show His Majesty what we've been working on? Form the think tank!
I'm thinking, right.
Machine, I love it. This is exactly
invented by a French chap called Pascal.
shall we?
Farrington, why don't you show His Majesty, tell His Majesty of your good English discoveries?
I'm thinking...
The pressure cooker, my love.
A British pressure cooker, I love it.
The French winkle, Papa.
French again.
I've had it up to here with foreign inventions by stupid foreigners. Vlogging, Newton, bring out the big guns.
I think you're comfortable. Oh.
people.
But now, I suggest we all leave and you kiss the girl.
No.
What? We're brother and sister.
Whoa! No.
Not so fast!
Mother!
There is something that I've never told you, children. I'm not your mother, fools. But we look so alike.
Chins.
Yeah.
All I wanted was to live with the father of my child.
What about the father of your next child?
So where is my father, the mysterious Filbert?
He left you this letter.
Dearest son... Fools. Sorry, I've been away so long I thought you'd forgotten me. Apologies for absence, always undercover, day and night. Watched you always, seen you right. Know this, your true mother was always at hand. Then if not Lady Winchester, who is my true mother?
Oh, Master Wolves! Quick, I'm there!
Swizzle? Swazzle? But which?
We don't know.
Well, both then.
I'm happy for you, fools. Now we both have a mother and a father, though mine is banished and nobody knows where yours is. Can you think of anyone who would love you as much as I?
Smethwick. Oh, if only you could speak, Smethwick.
I love you.
Well, nobody loves me!
Well, hello there, pretty little lady. My name is Salami, and I'm the lead singer of the band. And you're from Philadelphia.
Well, I think we'd make a rather delicious sandwich.
Oh, I'm too clever to be a maid or to be alone.
Oh, my dear, I know that we've only just met, but I feel myself gravitating towards you.
The chemistry.
Oh, electrifying!
Where shall we go, Master?
I cannot return to Holland. I have failed them. I will join my fellow pilgrims in the New World. I shall go to America.
Oh, I hear it is a great land of freedom. May I join you?
Of course, as an Ottoman, they may not let you in. They have orange men there of a different kind.
Welcome to Holland!